This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. In this video, we're going to go over some common terminology about angles, and knowing this terminology is especially useful before studying trigonometry. So we're going to discuss lines, rays, what a vertex is, initial and terminal side of an angle, what a central angle is, what an intercepted arc is, and define an angle in standard position. Now, most people have an intuitive idea of what a line is, but if you go up and look it up in the dictionary or online or in Wikipedia, you'll see a lot of different ways it can be explained, and some are pretty complicated. And we basically already know what a line is. Here's one that I saw in the online. It said, a line is a geometrical object that is straight, infinitely long, and infinitely thin. So it's that kind of a shape. I thought that was like kind of a simple way of describing it. It also consists of infinitely many points, but I'm going to assume you already really know what a line is for the most part. And you know, here's a picture how we might draw a line, but it really doesn't have any thickness at all. Okay? We have arrows on the end to show this goes on and on forever and ever in both directions. Now that we know what a line is, what's a ray? Well, a ray is defined as a point on a line together with all points of the line on one side of that point. So what I've drawn here, see how I have a point A and a B and an arrow going one direction. I don't have the arrow going the other direction. So a ray just starts at A and it goes through B and keeps going. And we call this ray AB. So the first letter is where the vertex is. Okay? Starts at A, so that's what you show first. And you're showing that you could write it as AB. So if you look right here, that's fine just to write it like that. It tells you that you're starting at A and going through B. And then similarly, here's another one. We have ray CD because it starts at C and it goes through CD. So we could write it like that. And that's the terminology for a ray. Now, if you look at this line down here, it goes through two points, GH. You could either just call this line L. Sometimes a line just has one letter. You're just saying, I'm going to call that line L. So you might call this line L, or you could also, if you have two points, you could just say, oh, this is line GH. You might see this, or you might see it written as HG, because there is no beginning and end point. It's just a line going through those two points. So that would be the terminology if you wanted to state what a line is. All right, so we've talked about line, we've talked about ray, and we need those two ideas to finally talk about what an angle is. And in basic geometry, here's how we define an angle. It's the union of two rays with a common endpoint called the vertex. So if you look at this picture down here, where I've got B and I've got an A and a C, I have a ray BA and I have a ray BC. Okay? So this is made up of two rays, BA, and you also see BC. And when you put those together, you get angle. Well, you could either call this ABC, or you could call it CBA, or some people just refer to this as angle B. And just note, B is the vertex, right, on each of those rays. So when I describe the rays down here, BA and BC, that's the first letter of the rays. Now, I'm doing this video because we're going to be getting ready to do some trig, although you don't have to do any trig after doing this video. But it's also common to consider an angle having an initial side and a terminal side. So I have this angle A here, and you notice I have an arrow drawing, like from this ray to that ray. And so where it starts, I call that the initial side, and where it ends is the terminal side. So it's saying the angle is kind of going in a certain direction. And here's another one, an angle B, where I have the initial side. You see I sort of have the arrow kind of going from the initial side to the terminal side. So here's an angle A, here's an angle B, and by looking at the way that I'm drawing this little angle, I said arrow, right? You can tell which is the initial side and which is the terminal side. So I have this angle right here, angle A, and you can see this is the initial side, right? Here's the initial side, and over here, this is the terminal side of the angle, and you can tell that because you see which way this little arrow is pointing, okay? Now, this angle has its vertex right here. This point here is the vertex, right? It's in the center of a circle, okay? When you have an angle where the vertex is in the center of the circle, it's called a central angle. So angle A is a central angle, okay? And the arc it cuts off, that's this thick green part here. It's called the intercepted arc. So this is an arc, and it's called an intercepted arc. It's like, where does it intersect the circle? Where does the angle intersect the circle? And actually, it's only intersecting here and here, but it's the part between on the circle between those two points is the intercepted arc, just to be very clear. Okay, we are almost done. An angle in standard position is located in a rectangular XY coordinate system. So we've got this, you know, X and Y axis, right? And the vertex is right here at the origin, and its initial side is on the positive Y axis. So again, I've got this thick coloring here to show you this angle A. And notice the initial side is on the X axis and the vertex is right here at the origin. Then that is called an angle in standard position. And here's two more angles in standard position, angle B and angle C. Just so you can see, it can go down, right? Angle B, notice the little arrow is going downward. And C, it could go pretty far. It could go all the way around to over here in the third quadrant. In fact, angles could go around and around and around. But for now, that's our basic angle terminology. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.